Hey everybody, welcome. My name is Andrew King, Managing Director here at WebSAN Solutions, and today I am thrilled to bring you some of my friends from Australia to feature Business Central Insights. It's advanced pre-designed Power BI reports for Business Central, and I want to welcome Dan and Sunny to this webinar today. So thanks guys for joining me.
Thank you, Andrew. We're really grateful to be here.
Thank you.
So a little bit about us. We're a Microsoft Gold partner located in Toronto, Canada, and Tennessee in the U.S. This year's Microsoft Partner of the Year, as well as an Inner Circle member and Canadian Partner of the Year for business applications. And the short answer is we pretty much do everything but finance and operations. And in our journey of continuing to find, you know, solid solutions for our customers, I happened upon my friends here from Australia and their collection of pre-built Power BI report. So I'll turn it over to them for an introduction of their firm and what they do. And we're also going to do a bit of a demo today for you.
Great. Thanks so much, Andrew. So we're a Microsoft consultancy firm based in Melbourne, Australia, with over 15 years of experience in the world of business intelligence and enterprise resource planning. We solve businesses' reporting and analytic needs through a suite of Power BI designed, pre-designed reports that gives in-depth insight into businesses' sales, finance, and operations. So far we have 11 apps, and it's very soon to be 12, with over 250 pre-built reports and over 1,000 measures. And our promise to everyone is powerful insight instantly. So you can find us at our parent company at enotion.com or Business Central Insights for the Power BI apps. And so today what we're going to do is run through about five of our apps. There's so much to show you, but we also don't want to bore you, although we're pretty sure that you're data lovers just like us. So as you can see, we have almost 12 apps, including sales, purchasing, inventory, finance, accounts receivables, accounts payables, cash flow, CRM, jobs, service management, and manufacturing. So we'll just take a peek at a few of these today, which is in bold here, the sales, inventory, finance, accounts receivables, jobs. And before I get into sales, I will hand over to Dejan, who will quickly show us our connector app and what that, how to link your company's data to our apps.
Thank you, Sunny. So I'll start by introducing our apps. So all our apps are available in Microsoft App Source. So you can download them from here by just selecting Get It Now button here. So once you download any of our Power BI apps, you will have a new workspace in your Power BI, and they will contain our demo data. But the best way we recommend for you to evaluate and test our apps is actually to connect our apps to your Business Central. So in order to do that, you'll have to install this connector app. This is a Business Central connector, and it acts as a bridge between your Business Central system and Power BI. So once installed, you'll find it in your Business Central. And I'll just quickly introduce some of the features of the connector app. So firstly, in the connector app, you'll be able to start your 30-day free trial. You'll be able to start and buy subscriptions and manage your subscriptions. But there's more than that. All our apps are multi-company, which means they support unlimited number of Business Central companies. And here in this setup, you'll be able to select which companies you would like to import into Power BI and which one is default one. You will be also able to select dimensions. So all our apps support up to 12 financial dimensions, including global dimension 1 and 2, customer group, salesperson, item group dimension. What is interesting about this configuration here is that that dimensions can be configured for each app separately, which means that sales app would have different dimensions to purchasing apps. Now all those dimensions will be then available in your Power BI reports on the right-hand side here in the filters pane. And you'll be able to filter all your data by any of the selected financial dimensions. In a similar way, you can select up to 16 item attributes. You can see that the item attribute one in our example is color. And again, you will have all those item attributes in your Power BI and you'll be able to filter. So if, for instance, if I want to filter only black items, I can see or blue items and so on. Each industry and each company is different and has its own key performance indicators and targets. Therefore, we have a set of predefined measures for each of our apps. And for those measures, you'll be able to select lower and upper limits, which means in our example, item profit is between 25-35%, which means if it's below 25, the color and icons will be red. If it's between 25-35, yellow and above would be green. So I'll just show you an example here, item profit. So those icons here will then be colored dependent on your setup here. And there is much more in our connector app, such as you can configure non-working days or holidays, aging buckets for your receivables and payables app, ABC classification, and much, much more. And now I'll hand over back to Sunny to introduce our first app, which is Sales Insights app.
Thanks so much, Dan. So at our Sales Insights app home screen, you'll see a list of our menu of pre-built sales reports that assist with different aspects of sales, where you can quickly find the information you need. I'll give a quick overview of here of these groups, which you'll see a similar structure in the rest of our apps. So in the customer sales invoice section, you'll find total invoice sales, which includes sales of items, resources, fixed assets, GL accounts, and other types. In the item sales invoice group shows data for invoiced item sales. All reports can also be filtered by fields and attributes. In the totem item sales, we'll give you consolidated item sales, including invoice shipped, ship not invoice, and outstanding quantities and amounts. The sales shipments group includes delivery days, variance on-time delivery reports. The resource sales section gives you a breakdown of invoice resources by various dimensions, and sales orders and invoice groups gives you outstanding orders and invoices. So there's a lot here, but I just want to show you a few of our key reports that we think you might be interested in. So before you start, you need to select the company that you'd like to see the statistics for on the left-hand side here. And then what we'll do is we'll go into the first report, the item sales overview. So all reports, when you get in, will have a menu on the left-hand side displaying the most commonly used filters, including year, month, dimension one, area, dimension two, industry. And for this report, we have included sales budgets, where you can select the sales budget to compare your actuals with. At the top of the page, you'll see an overview of year-to-date sales, budget, profits, and profit percentage, which all will automatically be recalculated if you want to know, for example, the sales profit for the month of August. So just click here, and you will see that the rest of the graphs are recalculated to show you just the August statistics, and you click again to see the total. So if you're interested in sales and budget by area, select the state to visualize the gap between budget and sales. And if you'd like to know how hardware tracked across your customer regions, then click here. Would you like to know why we didn't meet our sales target in September? Drill down to explore the weekly and daily sales. If you'd like to know the individual transactions, you can drill through to view. So it goes right down to weekly here, and then we go into the specific items in a separate graph when it comes up. And then you just need to click twice up on each of the graphs to get the bigger picture. In the total item sales overview report, you will have the ability to overview item sales as when we get in there. As invoiced, shipped, ship not invoice, outstanding, and total. So this is all on the left-hand side here. So that's very useful as well. In the item sales over comparison period report, if you'd like to compare the item sales for customer periods, we've got you covered for that too. So these sliders easily adjust for the time period contrast you require. So would you like to compare the last quarter of last year to the first quarter of this year? Just use these sliders up here, and then it will correspond in the item sales table as the current period, the comparison period is the next column, and the comparison item sales is shown there. And then also whether they're on target in the further graph. So quite useful information. If you'd like to know all about new customers and your customer acquisition, take a look at the new customers report, which gives you a good overview of the number of new customers per month. Would you like to know the new customers in August, for example? You can click here, and again, it will cross filter to the rest of the graphs. In the item ABC item classification report, which we'll go to now, if you'd like to know about your best performing customers or items, you can use these reports, which contain both item sales and customer sales. Here you can see the top 70% of sales. And again, you can set these classifications in the connector up in BC that Dejan just showed us. So for here in this example, 70% of our sales was made up of 51 of our best performing items. And the last 5% of our sales was made up by 27 of the items which are displayed here. And then we'll go to the item sales by salesperson dimension. So you'd like to know a bit more about your top performing salespeople. Here you can see all of your top performers. You can see how they're doing against budgets. You can also select a particular salesperson here, for example. We'll look at Esther, and Esther did about 11% above budget. And then I can see overall how she performed over different months and where it dipped over time in the right-hand side graphs. In the item sales returns reports, if you'd like info on item sales returns, these reports, you can filter on return reasons, which I think is particularly really cool. You can get specific items through selecting the reason, which will cross-filter and show the exact items and customers in the rest of the graphs. And then if you'd like to know a bit more detail about item sales by dimension, so if you'd like to review your sales figures by different dimensions, you can select from over 40 measures here on the menu on the left-hand side, and then 15 dimensions in the header here. The dimensions can again be configured in the BC Power BI Connector app. And so let's look at an example. Let's have a look at the item sales by item group. So what is our biggest seller? We sold over 1 million worth of wills, and we can expand here to see the exact items. And what are the most profitable? So if we have a look at the profit and click into the item profit here, we see that hard drives bring in the most profit, but we sold the most wills. If you'd like to go deeper, each of our apps have deep dive reports as well as dimension reports. And so our deep dives in customer item sales resources and sales orders and invoices, you can select multiple aspects of your data. So let's just say we want to know about total profits. I want to see profits by year, by month. Let's find out for August and by area. Let's select the Northern Territory. I want to know about customers and which items did we sell to Fast Services, for example. And then that will give us all of that here. So what else can you do in sales? We have on-time delivery reports, so we can find out the percentage of sales orders delivered on time, which is only 16%. The lowest on-time delivery items was spare parts and to which customer. In the delivery days report, on average, we can see that we are 1 point, let's have a look here. It's a bit slow. I apologize for that. We're 1.9 days late, which is found in the delivery days report and how late by customer. So as you can see with the sales app, there are so many more reports, including outstanding sales or invoices. You can check out the sales orders or sales invoices overview, which gives the overview of outstanding and ordered amounts. Again, this can be filtered by item and dimensions such as area, customer and salesperson. Also, just to note that every app has its own Q&A and key influencers section. So if you have questions, you can ask the Q&A. For example, let's just say we want to know the top 10 customers by sales. We can type that in here and voila, it will come up. So that's a super quick overview of our sales app and some of its functions. I'll quickly show you now purchasing before we hand over to Dejan for the inventory app. So as you can see on the home menu, there are over 40 reports in our purchasing app when we get there. And many of these purchasing reports are similar to sales reports and are grouped similarly. Again, you have the ability to set your own dimensions, go deeper into the analytics by multiple measures and dimensions, and gain new insights on where your vendors are at through these reports. So over to Dejan to introduce the inventory app.
Excellent. Thank you, Sunny. Let me introduce the inventory app. So inventory app is one of our most popular apps, and it has many tools and reports that can really optimize your inventory and reduce your cost and save you money. So I'll overview some of the reports. I'll start with the inventory overview. So on this screen, you can see on top of the report, you can see that the inventory value is 30.5 million. That is invoiced or actual inventory value. You can include expected costs as well, which are those costs that are not yet invoiced. And now you can see that the inventory value increased to 31.9 million. You can see that the previous year, this time, our inventory was only 10 million, which is 178% increase. Over this current fiscal year, daily inventory value average was 23 million, so throughout the year. We have 20,000 units in stock. It takes 636 days to sell our current inventory, which is 30 million, which indicates that our inventory turnover is 0.6. So in 1 year, we can only sell 0.6 of our total inventory. In those dollar charts here, on the left-hand side, we can see that in the last 30 days, we sold some of the items that represent 80% or 24 million of our inventory, which is a good sign. However, in this chart here, we can see that it takes over 1 year to sell 20 million of our inventory value. Of course, we can filter any of those measures by location. So in this example, I clicked on Melbourne and then it recalculated and show all this only for Melbourne location. In this chart here, we can see month by month, inventory value is actually increasing and that this is correlating to inventory turnover, which is decreasing over time because of that. So that's a bad indicator here. Let me continue with the inventory by period report. We find this report really useful because you can choose from up to 30 or over 35 different measures on the left-hand side here. And then you can display those measures by any time period. So for example, if I choose here quantity and balance, now I can see my inventory balance month by month for all of my items. What I can do here, I can drill on columns. And if I drill down, I will basically see week by week, and I can even expand to see the full week by week inventory movement for all of my items. Now, if I want to see values, I'll just click here, and instead of quantities, I'll see my inventory invoiced values.
So Dejan, I'm interested for Melbourne in January, just to see those details. Is that possible to see that?
Yeah, you can always filter by location. So for instance, I select location Melbourne. And now I will only see my inventory value for Melbourne. And that's the filter here available. Okay, I'll continue with inventory valuation report. This report is showing inventory valuation. It's similar to the static report we already have in Business Central. And on top of the page, you can select starting and ending date. In this case, we have from first to the end of the financial year. And then in the report, you will see the opening balances, quantities and values, all the increases in this time period, decreases, and the ending balance at the end as well. Now, again, you can see this as invoiced. You can see this as not invoiced or invoiced and expected. So you can add expected cost to this report, and this will recalculate. Right? Again, you can filter this by any location. For instance, I want to see Melbourne, what happened in Melbourne in this financial year. Even I can filter by month, for instance, January or December. So now I'll see here inventory valuation for Melbourne in December. I can even drill down to see the increases and decreases week by week or even day by day. Next report I'd like to show you is inventory by entry type. So firstly, I'll remove the filters so I can see the data for all locations and all months. So this one is showing inventory by entry type. You know that entry type, item ledger entry type could be sales, purchase, positive, negative adjustment, transfer, consumption, and so on. Now I can see here my inventory quantities or values by those entry types. And I can even compare, let's say if I want to compare purchases with sales, I can do that as well. And even drill down to see weekly or daily comparisons. Even choose budgets, can even choose balances instead of net change to see my balance for sales and purchase. Let's continue with day sales of inventory. We already touched this report with when we introduced the inventory overview, but what it tells us here that it tells us how many days it takes to sell our current inventory for any of our items here. And I can quickly filter to see those slow moving items that takes over 365 days to sell current inventory. So we have to look into those. Now, inventory turnover is almost like inverse report of the deficits of inventory. It just tells us how many times per year can we sell this current inventory level. So I can quickly click here and see the fastest selling items in this report. Let me continue with out of stock days. This report tells us how many days per year specific items were out of stock. We can compare this to cost of goods sold, which can indicate our sales of those items. And then we can see some of the best selling items, if they are out of stock most of the time, we probably need to look into that as well. But in our demo company, we can see that most of our items are in stock all the time. We also have inventory deep dive report here, where you can really select any of our measures out of 30, 35 different measures. And then you can drill down and explore by any attribute, any dimension in any order. So for example, I'll have a look at the sales in Adelaide, let's say, and I'll see exactly which items and I have my invoice value. I can quickly change to quantities and I'll see how many units did we sell in this financial year, 21, in Adelaide by item. We also have standard availability reports by location. You can see our availability of quantities and values by any location, and also item variant availability by location. This report is also interesting, availability by bill of material. So here you will have basically all items that are assembled or produced. You'll have their bill of materials and you'll have their components and subcomponents, so that you have multiple levels here, and for each component you will know the availability and where the bottleneck is as well. We also have projected available balance by period. So here, those reports can be used for planning, future planning. So basically, you will have all the measures available here, such as inventory balance, all your scheduled receipts, planned order receipts, your gross requirement, and then projected available balance that's calculated based on that. And much, much more. So we have Q&A, key influencers, and all of that. So, and that concludes my introduction, quick introduction to our inventory app. Now I will continue with our sales app. I'll continue with our finance app.
Finance app.
Yes. Okay. So the finance app, it contains lots of different reports, and it covers, the whole balance sheet, income statement reports, all profitability, and many, many financial ratios, which you will see later. Now, one of the prerequisites for the finance app is to configure GL account categories. So GL account categories is a standard functionality in Business Central. And what we did here, we added extra two columns here. So we added account subcategory Power BI and account subcategory to Power BI, which is just a drop-down list of standard subcategories. So this is a one-off setup that your finance or someone responsible for the finance will have to configure only once. And then all our reports will be ready. So we're using those categories quite a lot in our Power BI reports to calculate different ratios, because we need to have a standard classification of accounting groups. Now, I will start with the most, arguably most important financial statement, P&L statement. So we have a P&L statement here, we can actually quickly drill up to see our P&L statement categories, including those calculated measures such as net profit, EBIT, EBITDA, gross profit. So we have all profitability measures as well here. Year-over-year comparisons to budgets. So on the left-hand side, you would select which GL budget you would like to compare your P&L with. Now, the good thing is here, you can drill down. And yes, sorry, Sunny.
So I was just curious about if I just wanted to know the P&L for a particular state or region, like Victoria, for example, can we do that?
Yes. So in our example, region or area is one of our dimensions. So if I select Victoria here as a dimension one area, now P&L will recalculate and it will show only numbers for Victoria. So as I mentioned before, we have up to 12 financial dimensions, and you can see two of them here, area and industry, but the rest of dimensions will be available in the filters pane on the right-hand side here. Now, we can see here subcategories, but I can drill down again and actually see the individual GL accounts for each category and how we are tracking against budget for any of the GL accounts. Let me continue with the finance overview report. So the finance overview is really like a high level picture of your finance. You will have some of the important measures here, such as gross profit and margins and net profit and so on. It will have comparison to last year. So if we're tracking behind, then the color will be we have a balance sheet and income statement, quick snapshots. In this funnel chart, we can see that net profit only represents 27% of total income. You would also see that we have lots of descriptions of all the measures and formulas. So it's really clear how any measure is calculated. So we can validate your data as well. This little table here contains all the balances and net changes for our accounting categories. But if you want to see more details, obviously we also have a chart of accounts where you will see this on the GL account level. Now, let me continue with balance sheet overview. So the balance sheet overview will contain some of the balance sheet measures and ratios, such as current ratio, quick ratio, cash ratio, and so on. You would also see the ratios and comparison between current and fixed assets, current and long-term liabilities, and so on. Here we'll have a trend of current and long current assets and current liabilities over time. And you can see that the current ratio actually 3.2 indicates that current assets are 3.2 times of current liabilities, which is a good thing because our target is between 1 and 2. Now, because it's more than 2, it's colored green. Now, balance sheet table will have a detailed list of all your balance sheet general ledger accounts. Now, for each of them, you will have this sparkline. You can see the trend. You can see the comparison to previous year. You're able to compare to budgets as well. We have dedicated reports for assets, for liabilities, and so on. So assets will have some asset-related measures and ratios. You can see quickly that return on assets is 23%, and asset turnover is 0.86. Now, as we mentioned before, all of this can be explored by different dimensions. So if I choose any of the dimensions here, so we're looking at the assets by area. I can even drill down and basically filter further to only show bank, bank account. So now this will give me my bank account balance for different areas by month, right? And I can choose here any of the financial dimensions. Well, I'll just quickly remove this filter before I continue. Now, income statement, like I mentioned, we have many dedicated reports for income statement, where you would see all your income statement measures, how income, cost of goods sold, expenses are tracking over month or week, and so on. You can see the trend of net profit and gross profit margins and profits over time as well. We obviously have income statement in a table format as well. You have all the income GL accounts, expenses GL accounts, trends, comparing to budgets, and so on. And you can compare this by period as well. So any of your income statement or balance sheet accounts, you can see by quarter, by month, by week, by day, by any time period. And you can see it as a net change for budget as well. So in this example, I have all my income accounts, and I can even choose to drill on columns and show this by month. So now I can see my income GL accounts month by month or even week by week. Okay, we have a few reports for income, expenses, and costs, goods sold as well. So here you quickly see that we have a income comparing to selected budget month by month, and we can see which month we are behind or above our budget.
Dan, can I compare income versus budget on a daily or a weekly basis as well?
Yeah, we could do that as well. So I would actually recommend to first filter by month. So let's say if I'm interested in September, now I can see September, we're running behind, but then I can drill down to see week by week and even day by day in September. And always change to focus mode to see our daily budgets comparing to actual here. One of the features that I didn't mention before of our apps is also that we support daily budgets. So what it means that in your Business Central, you can configure monthly budgets. However, in our Power BI apps, we will break those into daily budgets. So that means you don't need to set up daily budgets. In BC, you can only set up monthly budgets. And then based on number of working days and all that, we will calculate daily budgets so you can actually track day by day. That's another feature of the connector app that I introduced before. So income, we have expenses, a similar report. You can track your expenses against budgets. You can see top 10 expenses here. And obviously in this demo company, we are spending way more than we budgeted. We have some profitability measures as well. You can see this in a table format or by period or by dimension. So any of our profitability measures, such as gross profit or margin, net profit, operating, EBIT, EBITDA, all that, you can see this by any period, by any dimension, or even as a decomposition tree chart here, and drill down into any order and explore this data. So the last thing for the finance head that I would like to introduce are our ratios, our standard financial ratios. So we have over 20, 25 different financial ratios in different groups. We have cash conversion cycle here, which is calculated at days sales of inventory plus days sales outstanding minus days payables outstanding. And you have all the detailed numbers here. We have efficiency ratios, such as assets turnover, inventory turnover, and so on, debt leverage ratios, profitability, and liquidity ratios as well. Now, all these ratios you'll be able to explore by any time period, by dimensions, and as a deep dive decomposition tree report as well. Our finance app also has a Q&A and key influencers as any other app. And that concludes my introduction to finance. Now I'll hand over to Sunny, who will introduce our accounts receivables app.
Thanks so much, Dan. Okay, so I'd like to introduce our accounts receivables, which I think is a really important app because it's all about optimizing your cash flow and ensuring your business gets paid on time. So at the home screen, you will see a menu of our receivables reports, which includes before due and overdue balances, receivables trends and aging, and paid receivables statistics. So again, you have to configure the aging groups in the Power BI connector app that Dan introduced at the start. Let's quickly have a look at the receivables overview report. So this gives us the total amount customers have to pay us. As we can see here, we have 79% of our invoices are overdue. So we obviously need to fire the receivables person. You can see in the reports that the red demonstrates the overdue amounts and the gray demonstrates the before due amount. The balance by customer is a useful graph, which shows us which customer owes us the most money and is the most overdue. So we can also decide to block them in BC. Over to the right, it shows us which salesperson is managing the overdue accounts, and the table on the right-hand side is a useful overview of customers based on their country and percentage of overdue balances. In the receivables report table, the table shows us customers which can be sorted by total open balances, and you can view the trend by due date. So we can see here that the on average how late they are paying in their account and in these columns. Okay, so in the receivables aging report, this is a handy table to view customer open balances by due period. You can drill up to see when invoices are due in aging groups and drill down to see balances by due month, due week, and due date. The before due and overdue report shows us the current open balances with due dates and how many days left to pay. On the right-hand side, you can see by aging buckets. So you filter the data through the donut chart and before and overdue balances, which will show you the before due and overdue invoices, and you can see in the table for when they are actually due. So let's click on those due between 2 and 7 days to show the customers owing within this time period, and you can do it for any other time period as well. In the document analysis, application analysis report, which we'll go to now, This report shows us the applied amounts by customers and when they're applied, so before due and overdue. So we can quickly see here that there has been over 32 million in payments and 7 million were paid overdue, and on average it took 16 days to close an invoice. In the receivables trend report, other than showing these incredibly pretty line graphs, if I do say so myself, it also shows the customer's open balances over time. We see up the top here on that the average overdue days for invoices to be paid, which is that being 271 days. In the right-hand side bottom graph, we see that the average days to collect against actuals closed in one nice graph, and click to expand, and you can also right-click to drill through to customer ledger entries as well to get individual. So then I'd like to look at one last report in this app, which is the customer statistics report. This gives us a handy table of sales and inventory amounts, any discounts, credit memos, refunds, reminders, payment discounts, etc. So everything you could want to know about your customers are all in one table here. So you can click on the customer to show how much we sell month by month, and it also shows the method by which the payments are being made. So do you want to know who paid by cash or PayPal? Just click here, which is pretty cool. Then I'd just like to show you the accounts payable insights app. It's very similar to our receivables report, which we just showed you. And this is all about vendor open balances, detailing who we owe what to and how long we're overdue for. And now I'll go into having a quick look at the cash flow reports app. So this will help you see your cash flow forecast over time and by any financial dimension, by source types, as well as an overview of bank accounts and balances over time. So please note that you will also have to set up the cash flow forecast in BC to use this app, as Dejan showed at the start. Then I'd like to show you a bit further, a bit more detail into our jobs app. So our Jobs Insight apps gives you better insight into your project budgets, actuals, sales and profits. So you can easily compare the profitability of each project or job you have. And this is how you can do that. So our first report to look at is the Jobs Overview. This report gives you a high level overview of how your projects are financially tracking. So it includes statistics for projects as a whole, or on the left-hand side menu, click on the particular project you'd like to see the figures for. So you might want to select the Canary project, for example. And up the top here, we'll then see the percentage completed, which is the percentage of budget versus actual costs. And it shows us that we're about one third of the way through here. The invoice price, or the billable price, is the percentage of what we've invoiced for the project, which is 78%. The planning lines are set in BC, and this statistic shows us the percentage of lines overdue, which in this case is 44%. The remaining billable price, what we're planning to bill in the future, is $13,500. So the left-hand side graphs gives a nice overview of the actual and budget invoice versus billable. The red colour represents the budget that has been exceeded for the month. So the pie chart is a nice summary of where the project statuses are up to. So if we unclick on here, and then we can see where all the projects are up to, which I quite like there. In the Gantt chart, you will see a high-level overview of the project statuses. By highlighting the relevant line, you can see the percentage completed, and the shading demonstrates task by task how much has been accomplished. So you can click on customers or individual project on the right-hand side to show where the stages are at in the Gantt chart. And then I'd like to introduce you to the jobs table. So this is a very smart table. Our customers say this table has saved their lives. Well, we're not actually totally convinced that it's really true, but we're really happy that it's made project management life so much easier. So let's take, for example, the search engine bandits. We can quickly see here that the budget and the actual costs, billables and job profit is reflected in the table. And just to note that the red circle again here has been defined in BC settings in the Connector app, where the profit below 25% is red, but you can configure these percentages again anyhow you like. You can drill down to see the job task structure or drill even further to see individual GL accounts, items or resources. So in the job comparison report, we're particularly proud of our job comparison report. Everything you want to compare within projects exists in this report. So the left-hand side menu gives you the many options for comparison. So select the measure that you want to review by price, cost, profit, profit percentage, and quantity. Then you can select between comparable measures. So let's just say we want to compare the cost between actuals and budget. Click here and voila, in a second, we will see the breakdown of jobs, tasks at the table, the variance and variance percentage. In the job profitability report, this report gives us some fantastic breakdowns of profit and recognised profit, which is, as you know, what has been recognised in the GL at a particular time. On the left-hand side, you can select the job and measure to compare. We can see here which job, customer, area and project manager is the most profitable, which are all handy insights into your company and projects. In the work in progress report or deferred job overview, it gives you the recognised profit in our GL accounts, which with the recognised profit percentage being 33%. We can view the deferred and recognised revenues and costs by project, customer or over time. The donut chart gives us a quick representational percentage of deferred and recognised revenue here. So you can click on any of those sections to get that reflected in the rest of the report. Okay, so we also have a service app. Now, Andrew has actually already introduced our Service Insights app. So you can check out his webinar from December where he shows some of the coolest features, I think. So this app gives you an in-depth knowledge of your service delivery. The app is grouped into service overview and service orders, where you can also get an in-depth look at your services and service products. Also, you're able to see your response times, fault and resolution analysis and cost amounts. Again, you're able to compare by period, how is your on-time response looking and what your profitability looks like over service, item and resourcing. So you're also able to check out your service orders by status and filter through by reason and so many more cool features. In our CRM app, this gives you critical data and highlights you may be missing from BC's relationship management. So would you like to see a better overview and snapshot of how your CRM, salespeople, campaigns and contacts are working for your company? These reports will help you see how your campaigns traveled over time or by period, by opportunities, including aging opportunities, and insights through interactions on how well different campaigns, segments or groups performed over time. There's lots of cool features here and I highly recommend checking this app out through our 30-day free trial. So, Dejan, how's the manufacturing app going?
Well, we're still working on it.
Gee, we're slow.
we're planning to release the manufacturing app, which we're really, really excited, in the next few weeks, in 1 month. So yeah, I'll encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel or to our LinkedIn to be informed when this happens.
Fantastic, guys.
Right.
All right. Is there anything else we want to show? We're moving on to...
I'd love to...
I got a few questions.
The last couple of slides. Oh, no, we've got a couple of last slides, I think, Andrew.
Yep.
Awesome. So I would just like to quickly overview what else we offer in terms of our reports. So you can create your own Power BI reports through connecting to our standard data set. So we can also show you how to do that. If you love Excel, you can download and analyze your data in Excel as well. If you'd like to see a particular report that you don't see, you can ask us and we'll add it to the next release free of charge. And our, as Dan mentioned, our manufacturing app is coming out in the next month. And If you'd like more than one app, we do packages. So on the next slide here, we see the packages that we offer. So if you're interested in any of our apps and would like to buy them now, then we are offering an extra month three, which means that's 2 free months. We're also offering free installation and setup and 1 hour of free training. So that's over $600 in value, which is free to you. And you can use the coupon code at the checkout, which is WebSAN2022. Really important to know that we don't have any lock-in contracts. You can cancel any time and you'll be getting new reports and features every month. We do updates every month. And installation is just in a few minutes. So you can complete the setup, the complete setup in under 30, which we can help you with, or you can do it yourself and follow our YouTube videos.
Fantastic.
So thank you.
Yeah, that's just amazing. Couple questions though. Does it, so does the app work on premise as well as for the cloud deployment of Business Central?
Yes.
Yes,
our apps, they work on premise as well. However, we require premium license for all on-premises installations.
Okay. And then for the end users digesting the reports, they require Power BI Pro license, I assume?
Yes.
Yeah,
they would require Power BI Pro or any other Power BI capacity, like premium capacity. Yeah.
Okay. But they don't necessarily require a Business Central license to get to the data, or do they?
No. Only Power BI licenses.
So it's just security through Power BI.
Exactly. Yeah.
Very good. Well, guys, like this is amazing content. And as I'd mentioned in even my own previous webinars, I mean, the reason companies invest in ERP and CRM, for that matter, is to get information out of them, right? And my humble opinion, you guys knocked it out of the park. So some amazing content, and the fact you keep adding to it is just great. So from a WebSAN perspective, I mean, we're starting to introduce this to our clients. We wanted to get this webinar together to really show and demonstrate the key capabilities of all these different modules. So highly encourage you to check out BusinessCentralInsights.com and contact Sunny and Dan to learn more. Great job, guys.
Thanks so much, Andrew. Really appreciate it.
Awesome.
Yeah.